Well, we're on TV again. This is Hilda Ward, and this is Artistic Expressions. And I'm so happy to have Claudia Bolaños. Did I pronounce it right?
Bolaños.
Bolaños. All right. I knew I was going to mess it up.
It happens all the time. No okay. worries.
And I'm so happy to have you on my show, Claudia.
I'm glad to be here.
And we met at the Bridge. And you told me that you did artwork.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, oh, I would love to see some of your artwork. And I'm excited that we were able to get you on. Right. And so now you grew up in what town?
I grew up in McLean, Virginia.
McLean, Virginia. And you attended UVA.
Yeah.
And when did you graduate?
2016.
Ah, so you're a brand new grad.
Yep, pretty much.
All right. And so what are you doing now?
At the moment, I'm at the UVA Curry School of Education.
Ah.
I'm preparing to get a license in special education teaching.
Wonderful, wonderful. We need all the teachers we can get.
That's what I've been told.
I was a teacher for many years, and I loved it. And I love going into the schools.
Yeah, I love it too. Yeah. I get to do it every week.
Right, right, right. Well, we're so happy that you were able to be on our show today. And so hopefully we're gonna get to see some of your artwork. But how did you get started?
You mean how did I get started
with
just
your artwork?
Drawing in general?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
I got started when I was about 4 or 5.
Oh, wow.
I think it started with just a general interest in looking at a bunch of Disney children's books, the ones with the really big illustrations to compensate for the really little pictures. I guess at the time I liked them enough that I tried copying them myself.
Great.
Onto paper.
Hmm.
You know, as I kept practicing doing that when I was little, it gradually became easier and easier. And when some other people saw me doing this, they would sometimes help me out by teaching me a few drawing skills themselves.
Wonderful.
And, you know, they enjoyed doing this. I enjoyed doing this so much that, you know, I just continued from there, and the rest is history.
Wow. And so how many pictures have you ever drawn? Have you ever counted them?
No. I've lost count.
That would take
forever.
Wonderful.
That would take too much time.
Right, I understand. I have a daughter who's an artist.
Oh.
And she says she can't count all of her artwork either.
Yeah.
And she teaches art.
Who even counts their art?
Well, some people do. But my daughter teaches art in a special school in New York. And so you two have something in common.
Yeah, I'd love to meet her sometime.
Yes. One of the things that I would like to ask you is, what does artwork do for you?
I'd say a lot of things. I guess for me, the purpose of artwork has changed a lot over time.
Mm-hmm.
In the past, I enjoyed it, you know, just for fun. And then starting in middle school, when I was thinking about what to do as a career, I thought, you know, I definitely want to pursue something art-related as a career, given how many people are happy and successful at doing that sort of thing. Like, you know, in the past, I specifically wanted to do just animated movies, but as time passed on, I realized that I had a lot of different options, and it was good to see that my art could fulfill a variety of purposes of, you know, pleasure, not just for myself,
right,
but for other people too, especially in education.
Yes.
Where I was surprised to learn art and education overlap much more than I expected.
Mm.
Like, you know, there's learning reading books that put a lot of emphasis on illustrations for early readers. There's foreign language tools that use a lot of pictures to avoid linguistic verbal barriers and so on and so forth. So I would say as a kid, art was mostly for pleasure,
right,
and then in my teen years, it was more work-focused as I was doing it towards a very specific, narrow goal. But now, I feel like it's evened out to, I guess, an even balance of both. It's pleasure for myself, the people I show, a good way to, you know, make friends and meet people who might have something in common with.
Mm-hmm.
And it's also work-related in that it becomes useful in a variety of work environments I've been in, and not just one.
Wonderful. Yeah, I think I can relate to that, because when I write poetry, I find that for me, it's coming through me. I'm not thinking about it from my head.
Yeah.
It just comes through me. But then when I go into the schools and share my poetry with the children and try to get them to write poetry, it feels so good that we can express each together.
Definitely.
Yes, yes, yes. And so that makes a lot of sense. So poetry and artwork, we kind of combine together.
Yeah, like there's this social aspect of art too, like you mentioned, and mm-hmm. that was the other aspect I find pleasurable, of not just making other people happy when mm-hmm. they see my art, making people happy knowing that there's someone else out there who enjoys doing art just as much as they do.
Right, right, yeah. That's what it's really. Ah, I see we have something on the screen here.
Oh, perfect timing.
Right. Do you remember doing this?
Yeah, it was actually during the first art class I ever took.
Ah, okay. So you did this in a class.
Yeah.
And it looks like a cathedral?
No, it's a willow tree.
It's a willow tree? Oh,
yeah.
My goodness. How did I see a cathedral? Well, see, that's another thing. The interpretations of art. The same thing with poetry. Everybody participates, and they participate in it in a different way. So, there we are. Now I see some trees. And where was this done?
This was a sketch done of the UVA campus.
Ah, yes.
Those two drawings were for an art class mm-hmm. where it was focusing just on charcoal drawings and just basically copying, drawing whatever you see.
Right.
Maybe because this was a class for, I guess, beginners in mm-hmm. charcoal drawing. So right. the focus was less on concept, on what you wanted to draw, and more based on how well you could draw whatever they assigned you.
So a lot of these are charcoal, you say?
Yeah, just charcoal, mm-hmm. scenery, still life, mm-hmm. that general sort right. of category.
And did you enjoy doing that kind of?
Yeah, definitely. You know, it was an easy grade for me, at least.
Now, that looks like a wonderful pathway.
Yeah. And another great thing about the class was it was actually where I met one of my closest friends.
Ah.
And out of all my friends, this was the one friend who we bonded the most over our shared interest in art.
Wonderful, wonderful.
And she actually still lives in Charlottesville, uh-huh. and we still keep in touch.
That's great, that's great. So you're doing a lot of sceneries here.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. As I said, I have a friend who tries to get me to do artwork, but I said, I think I'll just stick to poetry. Although, as I said, my youngest daughter is wonderful with her artwork. And I really am very proud of her mm-hmm. with some of the things that she does.
Oh.
I have some of her paintings in my apartment. Mm-hmm. She loves flowers and scenery, and she started when she was very little also, mm-hmm. and I didn't realize at the time how important it was for her in her life,
yeah.
you know. So I'm glad that you were encouraged to do it, because when I was raising my daughters, I didn't know the concept as important as it is. And I'm glad now that I did let them encourage, you know, get the artwork done. So all of my daughters are kind of in some kind of creative way. My oldest one was an actress. My middle one is an artist, and my youngest one was a dancer. So they all did creative things.
Nice, yeah. It's kind of a similar situation with my family as well.
Mm-hmm.
You know, my grandpa was an architect,
uh-huh.
and my grandma used to do a lot of pottery and painting
wow.
in her spare time.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, at one point, she was offered, I think, either a grant or a sabbatical or something like that, that allowed her to take some time off and focus solely on her artwork.
Wonderful. Oh, that must have been great.
Yeah.
Do you have copies of her artwork?
Sadly, I don't. Oh. But you know what? On my phone, I do have a picture of a building, of some buildings that my grandpa helped design.
Oh, wonderful. So you stay in touch?
No.
No.
He passed away a while ago.
Mm-hmm.
But the last time we went to visit his hometown, We passed by some buildings that I discovered that my grandpa was actually involved in. I was like, oh, whoa, this is a surprising thing to know now.
yeah, well, that's family history that I love to find out, because when I go into the schools, I try to get the students to ask their parents and their grandparents and their great-grandparents, if they have them, about what it was like for them. Because that's family history that we don't keep track of.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah, yeah. So I'm glad you had a chance to connect with your grandparents.
Yeah, especially a lot during my childhood when we went to visit them every year.
Ah, okay. Great, great. And I see some more artwork. That looks like a street.
Oh, that was like right from my house. It was just a bunch of cable wires from across the street.
So you were looking out the window.
Yeah. I think more specific, I was standing on the driveway right across the street, because you cannot get a view like this from my window.
Oh, I see. Okay. Ah, and what do we have? Ah, that looks familiar.
I thought so. Remember that, you said that you taught at UVA?
Yes, that looks kind of familiar.
You may remember this spot.
Yes. Oh, that's wonderful. That's a wonderful shot. Ah.
Yeah, you see a lot of these charcoal drawings were just scenery at the UVA campus.
And that was when you were in class.
Yeah, in class.
So actually, you were being told that you had to do this.
I was being told
rather than
graded on this.
What? Right, you were getting graded. Uh-huh. All right. So this one looks like, is that on grounds too?
Yeah, that is the little spot near Clemens Library.
Ah, okay.
The little spot near the library.
Mm-hmm.
This is by O. Hill.
Mm-hmm.
Remember O. Hill?
Yeah. Well, you got a lot of UVA there.
Yeah, remember I mentioned being a psychology major?
Right.
That's actually, well, that previous picture is the psychology department building.
Ah, yes. Okay, so that's
wonderful. So, yeah, I stopped by there a lot in the past.
Right, great. That's wonderful. So this, if you looked at your artwork, we could get to know a little bit about your life.
Well, I think that's how it is with all artwork.
Yes, it's true. Although some people claim it's not true, but the same with my poetry, even though I know for sure that a lot of my poetry has to do with my life.
Yeah, it's true in varying degrees.
Yes. Now, what would you like to do with your art?
Ideally, what I would love to do is have like a long-term employment at a film studio, particularly animation. And, you know, the best case scenario, I'll be involved in the pre-production stuff, like storyboards, character design, those two primarily, because that's what I feel like I'm best at.
But what is character design?
It's basically the job where you decide how cartoon characters are going to look.
Ah, wow. That's amazing. I never thought of that. Yeah. You know, I mean, that sounds wonderful. And where do the ideas come from? Do people give you ideas, or do you draw what they tell you?
They usually draw what they tell me, but sometimes they're very specific. Mm-hmm. Other times they're very vague, and they just let me do whatever I want, and then I show it to them, and then they and I will brainstorm back and forth on how to compromise to an idea, to a vision that makes us both happy.
Oh, good.
So it really depends on the situation.
Uh-huh. So do you think that you would ever do a book of artwork?
If I had time, I'd love to.
So right now, you're working at doing art, right?
Doing art and also studying at the Curry School.
Right, so you're going to become an art teacher.
Special ed teacher, right.
And that is so wonderful.
Yeah.
And I'm really happy that you're doing that, because we need teachers.
Mm-hmm.
And as I said, I love the fact that I can still go into the schools, even though I'm not technically teaching, but I am sharing my poems and getting the students to do some poetry. I think it's an important part of our lives, and we need to continue to encourage students to share their art.
Definitely. And it's also really important for, I think, teachers to share art too.
Like,
not just as a teaching tool, but also for raising awareness, especially
yes.
when it comes to fundraising events. Like, I'm not sure if you're familiar with the Allies for Autism. It's some sort of event in Charlottesville this April, And I read about the event online, but maybe it's going to be some event revolving art. But either way, when I saw the Facebook page for this event, there was like a big children's drawing to help promote it.
Wonderful.
So that's what I'm thinking of when I talk about using art for awareness as well as teaching.
Wonderful.
And I think now schools are becoming much more involved in the awareness function than before.
Wonderful.
And now awareness and teaching are starting to overlap with each other. They're no longer just separate things.
Right, yeah, and I'm glad to hear that because it's so important that we're connected. That was one of the things that I struggled with when I was a health teacher.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to share parts of me, but I also knew that I had to get the health interest in there also.
Yeah, and that's kind of my situation when I'm doing freelance work too. You know, as much as I want, there are some moments where I'm given a very vague prompt where I really want to express things how I envision them, but in the end, it's all going to come down more to what the clients want than what I want.
Mm-hmm.
Which itself is not a bad thing because, you know, oftentimes the clients come up with ideas that are equally as good as mine and sometimes even better.
That's great. Yeah, well, it sounds like you have found your niche.
Yeah.
Or at least for the time being.
I found a good niche to settle on for the time being.
Right, right. Well, that's great. And when you sit to do your artwork, do you feel like, for me, I can only talk about me, when I'm doing poetry, often I feel as if I'm meditating.
Yeah.
I wonder, does that feel that way for you when you're doing artwork?
It feels that way when I'm doing independent projects for myself.
Okay. All right. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. No, that makes sense. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So for me, usually I'm not writing for someone. If someone asks me to write a poem about someone, I really have to struggle with that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Whereas if I just sit down and a poem comes to me, that feels freer.
Exactly.
Yeah. Yeah.
And the great thing about independent, like, another reason they feel more meditative is that they don't have deadlines.
Right.
Or
right.
At least, you know, a lot of my work projects, they don't have deadlines either, but there's always the pressure to get it done as soon as possible. So at the very least, they don't come back to you five or so times saying, how's it coming? Is it done yet?
Right.
Can't
right.
wait to see it.
Yeah, but we have a gift, and that's a wonderful thing. There are lots of people who wish that they could have the gifts of artwork and poetry and writing and music.
Yeah, and I think another great gift artists have is the gift of passing that gift on
to others. Yes, yes. And you're going to be doing that.
Yeah.
And in special ed, I think that's very encouraging for young people to be able to feel that they're able to express themselves.
Yeah, especially when so many of them have difficulty expressing themselves in words.
Yes, yes.
Pictures
yes.
seem like the best alternative option.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I remember when I was getting, at the moment, I'm also getting an ESL endorsement.
Ah, okay.
And the professor for teaching ESL, she emphasized to me several times the importance of storyboards as a teaching tool.
What's storyboards?
Storyboards are like a panel of pictures.
Ah,
like
okay.
They're like a comic book, but without the comic bubbles.
Ah.
And those are a pre-production part. Those are the drawings used in the pre-production phase of animation, and they're essentially a guideline to what the animators use as a reference when actually animating the scenes.
Ah.
I probably should have put storyboards on the USB file to show.
Yeah, because, you know, it's wonderful that you're going to be doing this because often children who have special needs and are not always encouraged as much as they should be.
Yeah.
And I think it's important that you're sharing your artwork with them.
Yeah, and in my experience, I've seen the encouragement you're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
It really varies from district to district.
Yes, yes.
Like, you know, I've visited schools where teachers stick to the tried and not so true methods, and they're kind of just passively going through the motions. But I've also visited other schools where they're much more innovative and mm-hmm. creative and able right. to efficiently come up with new and sometimes more effective solutions.
Wonderful. Yeah. And that's
and that's the kind of school that I feel like I would love to work in, the kind of school I feel like, you know, I could help
right.
others.
Yeah. Well, when I was teaching, that was one of the things that I loved, being able to help young people express themselves, because that's something that is, I think, very important in our lives and also in the children's lives. Mm-hmm. And I think creativity is a way that, you know, I'm not saying that we don't have the basics, because we have yeah. to have the basics, but the creativity is the thing that happens, it comes from here.
Yeah. Yeah, and what would you say the basics of creativity are?
Well, that's a good question. Let's see, the basics of creativity. For me, it's not that it comes from here.
Yeah.
It comes from here. And usually when I'm just sitting and being quiet, then I just allow myself to be quiet, and that's when my poems will come. And I think that's probably the same thing that happens for you, even though you may not know it on a conscious level,
mm-hmm.
but for me, it's just letting myself relax and just letting it flow.
Definitely, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. And I think that's, what do we have here?
Oh, that was one of the independent projects I talked about earlier.
Ah.
It was actually some of my digital art. Mm-hmm. It was just an abstract drawing. Oh, and that's, remember when I mentioned character designs? That's an example of a character design.
Ah, look at that. And what does that say?
Persephone.
Persephone. Ah, that's wonderful. Ah, look at that. That looks like a fence and a...
What?
It looks like a fence. A fence holding a... Oh, wow, I don't know. I'm trying to see what
it's
I see.
It's a tidal wave with the face holding the trident.
Ah, oh, okay. Ah, this is...
Other character design?
Yeah, that's another... That's beautiful. Beautiful. I love the colors. And it's all, is that a full moon?
Uh-huh.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Another one?
Mm.
Yeah, you'll see all my character designs are done with digital art.
Ah, wonderful, wonderful.
Another one?
Yes. Wow, they are wonderful. Yeah. My middle daughter would love to see these.
Yeah. What kind of art does she do?
That's a good question. I don't know how to describe it. I know she did a lot of flowers and sceneries and characters and
her own characters or
yes, yes.
Wow.
Yeah. I don't know what she's teaching now.
Oh.
Yeah, so.
So she's a teacher also?
Yes.
Oh, wow, that's amazing. Mm. Oh, yeah, you already mentioned that she teaches at some gifted school in
yes,
New York,
yes,
right?
Yes, special school, yeah. Now, this looks like a parent with...
Oh, that's a character from a film.
Ah.
Do you remember a film called Rise of the Guardians?
No.
It was some DreamWorks film that came out a few years ago, and someone asked me to draw this particular character.
Ah, that's wonderful.
So this was sort of an independent project, too, mm-hmm. in that it was something done on my own time, but not for a specific
right,
project or corporation.
Right, right. Well, that's great. And so it sounds like you're picking and choosing, and yet you're working, and yet you're enjoying.
Yeah. For me, one of the hardest parts about my art right now is the choosing.
Mm.
Because, you know, recently there's been some hard moments where I've had to say no to projects offered to me for, you know, a multitude of reasons. I think one was because they didn't have a budget to pay me with for a film they were doing. Another time was because typically when I'm choosing what projects to work on, the factor in my decision process is not just money,
mm-hmm.
but also the content.
Right, right.
Because, you know, I don't want anything that would look bad on my resume.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The first time I said no to somebody, you know, they sent out a flyer saying, hey, we're working on a film, we need some storyboards, we need some pre-production crew, I offer to help out.
Mm-hmm.
They sent me the script, I look at it, and Even though, you know, story-wise, plot-wise, it was interesting, just some scenes I felt were suggesting some ideas and implications that I would not feel good promoting, I just thought were wrong, and I kind of had to politely tell him no. Well, but the funny thing is that, you know, artists tend to be not only creative, but also much more flexible and, I guess, empathetic and understanding than most people. Because when I told him the exact reason why I didn't want to do it, I was kind of scared, thinking, oh, shoot, did I just upset him? Maybe I should have just kept my big mouth shut.
No.
But surprisingly, he wrote back and said, hey, you make a really good point. You know, these are some things I hadn't thought of before. I will talk to my team about it and see what happens.
Well, that's wonderful, because it's not easy to speak up.
Yeah, and
say,
you know,
no.
In the end, even though they never went through with the idea, the important thing is that they actually understood and even liked it a bit. So
right.
I think the most important thing was that at least the understanding was there.
Right, great.
And that was a very surprising and just pleasant surprise.
But I'm proud of you, because it's not always easy for me to say no. So
yeah.
It was wonderful that you could tell them no. Because often we don't want to offend someone, but
yeah.
yet we know we have to speak up for ourselves.
Yeah.
So that's great.
Like, it's that hard choice between doing what's right for others
yes.
and what's right for yourself.
Exactly. Okay. Well, I can't believe this, but the time is almost up.
Oh,
my
time
goodness!
Flies.
Where did it go? And it's been such a wonderful time talking with you, and I hope you enjoy talking with me, and I'm hoping that we'll get to see some more of your artwork.
Yeah.
Yes, this has been wonderful. Claudia.
Mm-hmm.
I'm afraid to try your last name.
It's okay. don't forget the paper I
okay.
gave you.
Okay. Balan. Nope, we did it wrong.
It's okay. Bolaños.
Bolaños. Bolaños. Well, we got it. And I've been so happy having you. And I'm so glad we met each other at the bridge.
Yeah, and I'm so happy to meet you again.
Well, you're gonna get to see yourself on TV.
Yeah, and I'm really excited about
that. That's wonderful. You did well.
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.